Hey friends, it's Jessica from Three Rivers Homestead, and if you follow me on Instagram, through the month of August, I've been doing the Every Bit Counts Challenge, in which I challenged everybody to put up one food item, either through canning or freezing or dehydrating, just something every day through the month of August. And so I've been very busy posting over there on Instagram everything that we've been doing every day, but I haven't kept up much here. Today we have a very large food preservation project. We got 4 bushels of peaches yesterday, and we're going to be working really hard to get all of that put up. And so I thought I would share that with you, not so much as a tutorial on how to preserve peaches, because there's a million other resources out there to teach you that. But what I wanted to show you is how you can do this and keep your sanity with a lot of children in the house, especially small children. And so that's what I'll show you today. What we did first is kind of planned out the day yesterday, last night. I got all of my jars cleaned. I set up a system in the kitchen. I got the kitchen completely cleaned. What else did we do? We planned a really simple breakfast for the morning so that we knew we wouldn't create a bunch of dishes and mess. And then as soon as we ate breakfast, we got that put away straight in the dishwasher to keep the sink clean. And I delegated. I let my older children choose whether they wanted to watch little kids or help with the food. And as you can see, my girls chose to help with the peach preservation, and the big boys chose to watch the little boys for me. If you don't have big helpers, which there was a season of my life where I didn't, and I still did these large batches of food preservation, it just took a little longer. And what I would do is pick out an activity for the little kids to keep them really busy. Maybe it was a new coloring book, or I bought a cheap DVD of a show that they might enjoy, just something to keep them entertained and kind of out of the way for the majority of the day. Now, they're not going to do that the whole day, so at times I had to include them in the food preservation, and that slowed me down, but that's also important too. You're kind of teaching them to be a part of the process, so when they reach this age, they're eager to help. And so let's get started. I'm going to show you what's going on in the kitchen, and then we're going to get to getting peaches in the freezer and in some jars. Here is my kitchen. It's not very large, but it will get the job done. Over here we have a CD player, and the children generally pick an audiobook or some music that we'll listen to entertain us while we're working out here. I've got my jars all cleaned. I've got some bowls, a scale, my recipe book, pectin, everything we're going to need, a cutting board. Back here I've got dinner going in the crock pot. That's the key, because if you're canning large batches, you're not going to have the energy by the end of the day to make dinner. So do yourself a favor and plan a really simple lunch, like, you know, nut butter and jelly sandwiches or something like that, and then we've got a roast in the crock pot. That will save your sanity later on. And then I've got the girls over here. All these boxes are full of peaches, and they right now are working on scrubbing them clean and getting them laid out. And then meanwhile, I've got a very tired little guy here that we are gonna go nurse and get asleep. And then once he's sleeping, we can get to work. Oh, hi, Benjamin. Hi. Been about an hour so far, and we've managed to get quite a bit done. I'll show you the progress we've made so far. The girls have one batch of freezer jam almost ready to go in jars, and they're working on another one. And I've got 7 quarts of peach slices in here, heating up, ready to do a rolling boil. And then I'm working on cooking down all of this for peach sauce. So something you'll notice when I do canning, especially in large batches, especially with fruit, is that I leave the skins on for everything. My sliced peaches, my jam, even my fruit sauce. I do this for several reasons. First of all, I'm generally processing large amounts of fruit, and I have a very short window of time to get it done. Not peeling the fruit saves me time. I just make sure that it is thoroughly washed before I can it, that there's no leftover bacteria on the peel, and we're good to go. I've been doing this for nearly a decade, and there's no safety concerns on my part. But can at your own risk, because I know that they do not recommend canning with peels. Also, I do it because I want the added nutrition. For me, this is about filling bellies. I don't care how my fruit looks in the jar. I know some people wonder, will that mess with the color, and will it make the jars look not so pretty if you have the peels on them? And that is not my concern at all. This, for me, is all about filling bellies. The peels add extra nutrition and can help me get them in the jars faster. So that's what it's about for me. And so you'll notice that when I'm canning, that the peels are left on. The girls are still working pretty hard there on their freezer jam, but I'm out of space on my stove for now. And so I'm using this as an opportunity to clean up. And that's another piece of advice I have when canning with lots of children in the house or in a small kitchen or doing large batch preserving. Use every opportunity of downtime that you have to clean up. Otherwise, if you wait till the end of the day, it's going to be a disaster. And by dinner time, you're not even going to be able to use the kitchen. So right now I'm going to wipe down the counters, clean out the sink again to get ready for washing another batch of peaches, and let the girls finish up their job here. And we'll sweep the floor and get ready for round two. Hopefully I can time it so that I can nurse the baby in between batches here, but we'll see. He sort of runs the show right now. The girls just finished up their third batch of freezer jam, which is just such a blessing. That's three less batches that I have to do myself, and so I'm letting them take a break. And there's another tip. If you're relying on children to help you get through your preservation days, remember that they can't often push through and just get it all done the way we can. They need breaks to go do some fun kid things, and so I'm using this as an opportunity for them to go kind of relax a little bit, and I'm cleaning up the mess that they made, because remember, children as helpers are going to make a little bit more of a mess than we do. So I'm getting all their dishes done, the counters all wiped down, the floor swept up again, and while I'm between batches, I might as well make lunch for the kids. It's about 11 o'clock, and we don't typically eat lunch until a little later, maybe closer to noon. But you have to be flexible on these big canning days and just fit the stuff in while you can, because it's just stressful otherwise if you try to adhere to a rigid schedule when you have all of these other things going on. So remain flexible, let your helpers get some breaks, and your day will go a lot more smoothly. Little buddy here helping me now. So another tip for preserving when you have a baby. Benjamin here is 2 months old, and he's a very content baby. I am very blessed. I have had babies though that were not as content. So for the majority of my work, I can get him to sit in his little bouncy seat, and as long as he can see me and I kind of make gestures at him and play with him every now and then, he'll sit there contentedly, or I can get an older sibling to come down and kind of keep him entertained there. But there are those times where he's about ready to nurse, but you just have to push through and finish one little task, and you don't want him screaming. And so baby wearing is the key. I can't tell you how many days I've spent canning with a child on my back in a carrier, literally napping back there for 2 hours while I'm working. You just do what you have to do to push through the work. And so he's just riding out a little fussy spell right here. So as soon as I'm done getting this last batch of freezer jam done, I can go and nurse him, and then he'll be content probably in his bouncer. But baby wearing is a wonderful thing. Just be careful if you do have a baby on your chest and you're near a stove, that you can burn little toes that are hanging out and things, or hot water can splash up at them. So just be very careful. Being on the back is ideal, but there are times when they're little like this where they may not feel secure back there, and so you just put them on the front and you make do. All right, I'm gonna go nurse this little guy and take a break. Okay, so here is what we got done today. I think this is 3 batches of sauce and 1 batch of slices. And then this is a batch of freezer jam that came simply from boiling down the peach pits with the attached fruit. So that's awesome. That will be added to the freezer. Another little batch of freezer jam. And then we got some sliced peaches to use for smoothies. A little bit left over here that I'm going to feed to the kids here for a snack. And then on top of that, the girls had 11 half pints of freezer jam they made this morning. So not bad for a day's work. Is it good? Let me see. It's been a pretty hot day in the kitchen with the canner going and without air conditioning. It's been pretty steamy in here, but I feel happy with what we got accomplished today. I got through about 1 3/4 of a bushel. So that's good. We're about halfway there. And tonight after the kids go to bed, I may do a little bit more work, but I feel like it's almost 4:30. So we've been at it since 9:30 a.m. with a couple breaks here and there, but I'm ready to go play with the kids and have dinner and just kind of do something else until the kids go to bed. So I hope you enjoyed kind of getting a peek into how we do our canning with the kids, and we will talk to you later. Have a blessed day, friends. Is it good?